Oh, hi everybody. It's time to do a lessons learned video for my 2013 garden. I've actually made this video a couple of times, but now I've got to redo it again. It appears that I've got some internet troubles, and my download and upload speeds are very restricted for some reason. But I'm going to have to do these in short videos, very short videos, and make several of them, because this was like something like 10 to 12 minutes long originally. But it's going to be the first one, and the first thing I want to talk about is the weather. Lessons learned. We've got to be prepared to adjust for the weather. I think most gardeners already know this, are highly experienced, but the last couple of years, especially this year, has really pushed that home to me. We've had lots of rain, and it was very cold. And just speaking for myself, I think that I'm going to have to look into polytunnels, a small greenhouse, in order to be able to germinate all my seeds and everything. This year, I had to wait so long to put my stuff out. Man, our entire house looked like a jungle before I could finally get it out. And then, when we did get it out, we'd have these odd times where it would stop raining for 2 or 3 days and get very, very hot. And it really stressed the plants out badly. I lost almost all of my squashes. I do have a few out here that you'll see in some of the following videos. But the weather, just think about your situation, where you're at, what you might need. For me, I'm definitely going to have to look into a couple of polytunnels, hotbeds, and possibly a greenhouse. Everybody's situation is different, so think about your situation. How can you adjust for the weather? How can you prepare it? Now, I mentioned for me, polytunnels would be good because it's so cool so much later into the spring. Another option is, I guess it would depend on how big your garden is and stuff too, but now if you could set up frames with tarps or something over things, and this might work well over raised beds where you're actually putting a cover over it to prevent the rain from getting down in there. Where I'm at, I actually see that quite a bit, where people are putting covers over their plants, and it's done also to help prevent too much rain, but also to give some shade to them. So that's just something to think about. Think about your situation and see what kind of ideas you can come up with that would help you to adjust to different changes in weather.